Thank you. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. That was Mozart's New World. How about that? We're going to go back to the marimba and drum kit, I think, on this one. I thought every album isn't complete unless you put a concerto on it. And I thought, well, let's not put a normal concerto on it. Nothing else is normal, so why should we put something normal on it? A lot of this is written in 7/8. So that means you have to play and go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, like that. Most people can't even feel that. They can't feel the time of that. So this was really, I just wrote it as punishment for all of us, because we thought we too often play in 4/4, which is the same as 8/8. So we thought we'll just knock one quaver off the bar and see if we can keep it in time. But the clue's in the title. It's called Russian Mambo Concerto. The Russian bit is because of the Russian influence in it, because there's a little bit of tune in the middle. Did anyone notice the Mozart's piano sonata in A, in the middle of the last tune? There was a little bit of that in there. And you're allowed to do that, you see, because it's all out of copyright. This next tune has also got a little bit of a Russian composer called Glinka, who not many people know or have heard of, but he did some nice tunes. And again, that's all out of copyright, and there's a very small bit of his. And usually that's how a lot of my stuff is completely original, but the ones where I have snippets of ideas, I then built this whole Russian Mambo Concerto around just a few bars of Glinka's music. So it's got a nice Eastern and Arabian Russian sort of feel to it. And then it goes into a mambo, which comes from North America and Cuba and that sort of way. So I don't know how that happened, but this is the rushing bit is because it rushes, you see. It's called Rushing Mambo Concerto. Thank you. there we are, Russian Mambo Concerto. That's the whole principle of that. If you see what we're doing, we're having conversations with each other, which is why the album's called Classical Conversations, because that's what they're doing with each other. I've also written an essay that goes with this new concept. Because see, a lot of this material is written, some of it's improvised, other bits are sort of sketch written, so I give rhythms and clues to the musicians of what to do, but they're still free to then do other things with it. So it's, you know, that's why it's not jazz that we're doing. It's classical music, but a little bit different than it's been for the last 500 years. But we're going to do, we did earlier a piece, The Way of Things was the first movement from my Finchcock suite. The Finchcocks was a musical museum that closed down recently, but I used to work there a lot. And I did a suite, a four-part suite. So the first one we did earlier, Way of Things, this is the third movement, and it's called simply The Finch. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Is that okay? Yeah. Thank you very much. That was the Finch. I do usually like to play a real piano as opposed to a plastic one, because we try to keep it as acoustic as possible. Even Dominic's guitar is actually semi-acoustic. It's an arch top semi. I had to think of a fancy name for it, because on the album we've got Duncan with umpteen instruments, me with umpteen instruments, and then I came to the list for Dominic and I thought, I better give it a fancy title. So I called it a semi-acoustic arch top guitar. How about that? Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to do one more number. Come to the end of the evening, and you've been a very lovely audience. And this one actually started off this whole thing, actually, this whole idea. And this tune I used to do with that guitarist Clive Hicks. And until I found Dominic, there wasn't any guitarist brave enough to try this tune out. Or silly enough, he says. Yes. But it's based upon Flight of the Bumblebee. And it's the first track on our album. And it's got a nice Spanish flavour to it. And it's called The Blight of the Spanish Humble Bee. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. That was just a little ditty for a bit of exercise for me. I've got to put all these back in the van and bring them home as well. But you've been a lovely audience. Lovely to see so many of you coming out tonight. Please do buy a CD. It's good quality stuff. If you don't like it, use the CD as a coffee mat. And then the CD itself, you can hang on your Christmas tree at Christmas because it catches the light nicely. If you're really tight and you don't like spending money, there's a download card that you can buy, and that's £4, which means you can then go online and download all the tracks. Or you can just download separately, and it's about £6 or £7. But each CD is £7, or for two CDs, you can buy them for a tenner for two. How about that? But ladies and gentlemen, you've been a lovely audience. Okay, we'll just play out one to send you sleep tonight. It's the last track on the album. I'm working with a BBC news presenter at the moment, and he wrote some lyrics to this. And it's basically a little love song, and it's called I See You There.
Thank you.